Hello friends, hearty welcome to you. In this session, let us try to understand the proof of Ceva's theorem. Given a triangle ABC, let the lines AO, BO and CO be drawn from vertices to a common point O to meet opposite sides at D, E, F respectively. Then the theorem states that AF by FB into BD by DC into CA by EA equal to 1. So we have taken a point O inside of triangle ABC, interior of triangle ABC, and through ABC we have drawn line segments to the opposite sides like AD, BE and CF. According to the theorem, AF by FB into BD by DC into CA by EA equals to 1. Now, how to prove this particular theorem? For that, what we will do? Let's take the triangle whatever given to us. First, we have AF by FB. So, let's try to understand what triangles I can see with base as AF. Let's write them down. With respect to AF as base, I can see two triangles. One is triangle ACF, another is triangle AOF. And similarly, with respect to base as FB, I see two triangles. One is triangles BCF and another is triangle BOF. Now, let us take, consider triangle AOF and BOF. Triangle AOF and BOF are on the same line AB and between the same parallel lines. If I draw a line through O parallel to AB, then I can say, let us say that this height is equal to H1, then we can say that area of triangle AOF divided by area of triangle BOF is equal to AF by FB because their altitude with respect to base AF and FB is same, that is H1. Similarly, if I consider triangles ACF and BCF, I see that their bases are in the same line and they are between the parallel lines. If I am able to draw a line parallel to AB through C, then I can say that their altitudes are, for both of them, the altitude is same. Let us say that is equals to capital H1. Now let's write down what's the areas of these triangles with respect to the bases as AF and AB. I'll write down. First, what is area of triangle ACF? That is equal to half into AF into small h1. What is area of triangle AOF? That is equal to half into AF into small h1 and this is capital H1. Similarly, can I write down area of triangle BCF? That will be half into BF into capital H1 and area of triangle BOF is half into BF into small h1. Now, if I do subtract area of AOF from area of ACF, I will be left out with area of AOC. Similarly, on the other side, I will be left with area of BOC. That will be equal to AF by FB. Let us see that how it is. So, let's go to the next statement. In the next statement, we will write down area of area of triangle ACF minus area of triangle AOF divided by area of triangle BCF minus area of triangle BOF. Since it's AF by FB, we are doing in detail, but we can do the same thing for the remaining. Once we are done with this, understand how the pattern goes. Now, what is ACF? Let's write down the formula for ACF. I'll write it down here. Let's substitute the values, whatever we have earlier. So, can I say half into AF into half into AF into H1 minus half into AF into small h1 divided by half into BF into capital H1 minus half into BF into small h1. What will be the next step? The next step will be I can take half common, I can take AF common. I am left out with h1 minus h1. In the denominator, I have half into BF or FB into again h1 minus h1. I can see that half, half I can cancel out. I can cancel out h1 minus h1. So what is left out is AF divided by FB. So AF by FB is equal to, what is this actually we are talking about, ACF minus AOF? What is this? This is area of triangle. ACF minus AOF is area of triangle AOC divided by area of triangle BOC. Can I write down here? AOC divided by triangle BOC. So we have AOC divided by BOC, area of triangle AOC by BOC equals to AF by FB. So successfully we are able to transform AF by FB into area of triangle AOC by area of triangle BOC. By this time you should have understand that we have to follow a pattern so that when you multiply them, all of them will cancel and we will get it as 1. So let's remember for now that area of AOC by area of BOC equal to AF by FB. We will quickly go through how we can write BD by DC and CE by EA. Since it is AF by FB first one, we have looked into that detail. In the second and third, we will finish it quick. So let's go to the second one now. Now let's go to the next set of, that is BD divided by DC. When I look at BD, I have two triangles. One is BOD, another is BAD. Similarly, when I look at DC, I have two triangles, DOC and DAC. Can we apply the same logic whatever we did for AF and FB? We can easily prove that BD by DC equals to, BD by DC will be equal to area of, we take BAD, from that we subtract area of BOD. So we are left out with area of triangle AOB divided by, for DC we take DAC minus DOC. So we are left out with area of triangle AOC. Now you can see that in the first one we got numerator as triangle AOC area. Now in the second we got the denominator as AOC. So that means they will be cancelling it out. Let's go to the next one now, CE divided by EA. When I take CE divided by AA, CE, on CE I have two triangles. One is COE and another is CBE. If you subtract one area from the other area, you are left out with BOC. We have seen that will be in the ratio of BOC by BOA or AOB will be in the ratio of CE by EA. So can we go ahead and write down that? CE will be area of triangle BOC divided by area of triangle EA. For EA it will be EABE minus AOB, AOE. I'll show you that. This is ABE triangle. This is AOE triangle. We have seen how we have proven for the first one. We see that area of BOC divided by area of AOB will be equal to CE by EA. So can I write down area of BOC divided by area of AOB? We are done. So since we have AF by FB, BD by DC, CE by EA, now we try to multiply them. So we multiply this. We can see that numerator and denominator, everything cancels out and we get answer equal to 1. So that's a proof of the theorem. Let's have a recap of this. Ceva's theorem states that if O is a point interior of triangle ABC and where line segments are drawn from vertices to the opposite sides like AD, BE, CF passing through the point O, then AF by FB into BD by DC into CE by EA, you can see that we are going in one direction continuously, AF by FB, BD by DC and CE by EA equal to 1. Now what's the logic we have seen here is AF and FB are on two sets of triangles. AF is on AOF, AF is also on ACF. For both of them I can take AF as base. Then similarly BF, BOF and BCF. ACF, BCF are on the between the same parallel lines. Similarly AOF, BOF are between the same parallel lines. So when you subtract their areas you get AF by FB. Similarly, so what we got now is AOB we got when we taken AF and FB, we got AOC by BOC, AOC divided by BOC equal to AF by FB. Similarly, BD by DC equals to AOB divided by AOC and CE by EA equals to BOC divided by AOB. When you multiply all of them, you get 1.